discussing about non-homogeneous. Linear ordinary differential equation. Okay, this is again with constant coefficient. Okay, so for a second order differential equation. So you have this standard form y double prime p of x y prime plus q of x y. Okay, since this is non-homogeneous, therefore you have now function on the right side in terms of x, which we denote by r of x. Okay, so how do we get the general solution in this type of differential equation? Okay, the solution to this will be composed of two solutions. Okay, again, this one, y sub h, is the homogeneous part of the solution. Okay? Ang solution ito, when this is equal to 0, or the homogeneous part of the solution. And then, itong y sub p, this is what we call the particular solution. Now, this particular solution will be a function to this, or based on the function na nandito sa right side. Okay, in order to solve this one, we have two methods. Okay? First is method of undetermined coefficients, method of undetermined coefficients, and another one is the variation of parameters. Now, we will discuss these two methods. Okay. First, we will start with the method of undetermined coefficient. Okay, so para ma-solve natin yung differential equation using this method, we need to have table. Okay, this is the table that we will be needing in order to solve a non-homogeneous ordinary differential equation using method of undetermined coefficient. Okay, this is table 2.2 taken from the book of Wiley. Okay, so here you have certain functions. So ito yung mga functions na possibly na nandoon sa right side portion ng iyong equation. First, it is possible that you have a constant. And then, second, a constant multiplied by x to raise to any exponent. Okay? Ito, number three is for functions that has e. Okay? Four and five for having trigonometric functions. And six and seven are combinations of this. Okay, so ito lang yung tatandaan ninyo kung ito yung corresponding choice mo for a particular integral. Okay, so just familiarize this one. Okay, for ito, for number 2, so if you have an exponent raised to 2, so you have a constant x squared plus x plus constant. Okay? Okay, so for example, x squared, yung corresponding choice for y sub p will be having like this one, ax squared plus bx plus c. Okay, I will erase this one. Example, kung ang right side portion mo is 5x squared, your y sub p will be ax squared plus bx plus c. So from one function naging tatlo. Okay, kung ganito yung r sub x mo. Okay, we will have an example. We'll have an example. This one. Y double prime plus 4y prime plus 3y is equal to 5e raised to 2x. Okay, again, the first part is you get the homogeneous solution. You have set mo to 0 to get the homogeneous solution. And then the characteristic equation for this one would be m squared plus 4m plus 3. Factoring this out, you have this one. Therefore, your roots would be negative 1 and negative 3. Therefore, your homogeneous solution is you have c1 e to the negative x plus c2. Okay? So, basic. Now, we will go to the other part of the solution, which is finding the particular integral, particular solution. Okay, so based on the right side, we will apply number 3. Okay, so ito yung magiging choice mo for a particular integral. Okay, constant, just copy this one, e to the 2x. And then, anong gagawin natin kung makuha na natin ito? I-substitute natin ito in the differential equation. Since merong y double prime, merong y prime, so we will get the derivative of this one. So you have y prime of p is, and then y double prime is 4a e to the 2x. Okay? And then we will substitute this one dito. Erase this one. Ito, remain lang natin ito. So you have 4 a to the 2x plus 4 times 2a is 8a to the 2x plus 3a e to the 2x. This is 1 is equal to 5e to the 2x. And then you'll just add this one. 8 plus 4, 12 plus 3, 15. A is just 1/3. A is just 1/3. Okay? Okay, by the way, if you recall, y sub b is a e to the 2x. So meron na tayong value nitong a, so therefore it becomes 1/3 e to the 2x. Now your general solution is just a combination of the homogeneous part plus the particular solution. Okay, therefore your general solution is c1e negative x plus c2e negative 3x plus 1/3 e to the 2x. Okay? So that's it. That's your general solution. Yung example natin is second order, but the same process applies for third order, fourth order, or fifth order. Okay, let's have this another example. Y double prime plus 5y prime plus 6y is equal to e negative 3x. Again, first get the homogeneous solution. You have d squared y plus 5 dy plus 6y is equal to 0. Your characteristic equation is m squared plus 5m plus 6 is equal to 0. And then you can factor this out. Your root now is negative 2 and negative 3. Therefore, your homogeneous solution is c1e negative 2x plus c2e negative 3x. Okay. Let's solve for the y sub p. Okay, based on the table, this will become a negative 3x, right? And then we get the first and second derivative. Okay? Then let's substitute this here. You have 9a plus 5 times y prime negative 15. This is now negative 15 e negative 3x plus 6a. E negative 3x is equal to, we'll not erase this one. Lagay natin ang y sub p dito. Okay. Equal to this one, E negative 3x. So we add 9 plus 6, 8, 15a minus 15a. So this is 0 is equal to 1. So, ano nangyari? This cannot be. Huh? 0 is not equal to, or we have not get the value of A. So, wala tayo nakuha ng particular solution. So, ano ang, where is the problem? The problem is, itong choice of YP mo, based on the table, A, E, negative 3X, is just the same, this one. Same lang siya sa, dito, sa part sa homogeneous, meron siyang term na kapareho. Okay? This one, which is this one. Constant times E negative 3X. Constant times E negative 3X. So, according to the rule, hindi pwede na magkapareho yung particular integral mo sa term mo dito sa homogeneous solution. So, kailangan mong i-compare yung dalawa. Okay, once you get the homogeneous solution. So, ang gagawin dyan is, instead na ito, multiplyan natin ito ng x. So, this will now become, okay, ax e negative 3x. In the event na mayroon naman itong kapareha dito, so multiply ka na naman ng x. Pero dito, wala naman. So, this is now our particular integral. So, we get the first derivative. The second plus second the first. Okay. This is a okay, therefore your y double prime is first the second plus therefore, your y double prime is just 9ax e negative 3x minus 6 e. Okay? So, i-substitute natin yan dito. You have 9a. Plus 5 times this one, so we have negative 15ax plus 5a a negative 3x plus 6a A is equal to A negative 3x. Okay? And then we group the terms. Okay, so this one, 9 plus 6 is 15. Meron kang negative 15 dito. So, cancel pala ito. So, yung remain is just negative a negative 3x. A is just negative 1. That is now the answer. The general solution would be solution is y sub h plus y sub p c1 e negative 2x plus yp a is negative 1 so minus x e negative 3x. This is now your general solution. Okay, our third example is y double prime plus 3y prime plus 2y is equal to 10 e raised to 3x plus 4x squared. Okay? So, if you have two terms, pwede mo itong in getting your particular integral, pwede mo itong hatiin sa dalawa. Okay? Your y sub p ito, pwede mo hatiin sa dalawa. Ito yung y1 mo, ito yung y2, and then get the particular solution. Once nakuha mo na siya, pwede mo i-combine. Okay, pero hindi natin yung gagawin dito, but instead solve this as 1. Okay, first, you get the homogeneous solution. And then, your characteristic equation is m squared plus 1. You have n plus 1, n plus 2, plus 0. Okay, therefore, your homogeneous solution is c1e to the negative x plus c2e negative 2x. And then your yp, okay, dito ko na lang ilagay. This one is number 3 and this one is number 2. So you have bx squared plus cx plus d. Okay? I will now erase this one. Ito, ilagay ko sa dito sa bottom. Okay, so let's get the meron bang same term dito? Wala. Okay, so let's proceed in getting the first derivative and second derivative. You have okay. And then let's substitute this one here. So you have 9a to the 3x plus 2b plus 3 times this one. So you have 9a plus 6bx plus 3c plus 2 times this one. Plus 2a to the 3x plus 2b x squared plus 2c x plus 2d. Okay, now erase this one. Is equal to 10 e to the 3x plus 4x squared. Okay, let's add those terms which have the same variable. This one, 18, 20, 20a, e to the 3x, plus all the terms, so this one is finished. All the terms that has x squared, so isa lang plus all the terms that has x, so finish na to, plus x times 6b plus 2c, and then all the constants, 2b plus 3c plus 2d is equal to this one. Okay? So in order for this one to be, to have the equality, so all the terms dito, example, itong may e to the 3x, dapat equal dito. So, you have 20a e to the 3x is equal to this one. 10 e to the 3x. And for a is just 1/2. A is 1/2. And then all the terms of my x squared therefore b is equal to 2. And then this one, 6b plus 2c is equal to 0. Therefore, c is just negative 6. And d, this one, D is equal to 7. Okay, since we already now have the value of the constants, gonna apply or substitute here. So I will not erase this one. Therefore, your y sub p is equal to your particular solution. Particular solution is e to the 3x over 2 plus 2 x squared okay. This is your yp. Now your general solution is the combination of these two. For y is equal to plus okay, that is now your general solution.